For whatever reason, I've been having a lot of Bigfoot news come across the front office. And so I will I'll bring this up. So I got a couple quick ones. And this first one is a news report out of New York dealing with Bigfoot. So we'll play this, and I'll bring up some of the other two most recent Bigfoot sightings, and we will all look at that together because the footage is fairly interesting. So we'll take a look at that. And let me bring this up, please. Yes, here we go.
Few creatures in the wild attract more controversy than Bigfoot. The legendary primate has been an enigma for centuries and continues to fascinate. Mayville resident Peter Weimer has been sponsoring an annual Chautauqua Lake Bigfoot Expo since 2012. The outpouring of eyewitnesses since then has many believing that Sasquatch may be living in the area.
They are from all kinds of walks of life. If there's 45 eyewitnesses that have reached out to me, there's 100 or more in Chautauqua County that aren't talking to me.
The county is lush with dense forests and deep gorges that would offer such a large animal plenty of space to remain concealed. Their habitat requirements are very similar to the black bear, a common but seldom seen species in the area.
There has been published data that indicates that examination of the bioclimatic factors that establish a black bear's population seem to also run very parallel to those attributable to Bigfoot based upon its reported distribution.
Skeptics often point to the lack of physical evidence such as bones to discount these animals' existence, but that's not unusual with any animal.
You know, to find a dead bear in the wild is unheard of. Same thing with a coyote or a fox even, because the environment has its own disposal system.
Footprints are confirmation of an animal's presence and are impossible to hoax. Many have been found in Chautauqua.
Okay. Footprints tell us a lot of things.
Here we go. So first of all, yes, because there are no bones and this is all bullshit. We know this, and I know you love this stuff, but there's tons of it. I mean, there's more evidence that he doesn't exist than he does. Or she, whatever the fuck. Can you milk a Bigfoot? I don't know. Maybe. But let me say, I just looked up bioclimatic. It has to do with architecture. This guy he's full of shit.
So if in that way he used bioclimatic, he was referencing architecture, you think? Like he was talking about...
I just looked it up. That's what bioclimatic has to do with. It's an architectural term. The guy is just saying fucking words he heard at some point. And then it's good, you know, oh, I know about Bigfoot and this is a real thing. Somebody fucking give me attention.
Hold on. Well, maybe he just misused the word. That happens a lot, Joe. And maybe he's the not most well-read of Bigfoot researchers. And that happens.
And look at all the books behind him.
Yeah, he does have a lot of books. So
they're all Nancy Drew.
No. There's some Scooby-Doo back there.
Tom Swift.
Let's finish this news report because it's very critical.
The hoax. Many have been found in Chautauqua.
Footprints tell us a lot of things, too. I mean, not only the presence of something, but obviously, like I mentioned earlier, something about its distribution, its movements across the landscape.
For those convinced of its existence, the proof is out there. And always has been.
This mystery does go back centuries. If you think about it, you know, not only do you have the Native American lore, but throughout history,
whether they're humanoid or more animal, that is still to be figured out, but they're there.
Taking you to the outdoors, I'm Terry Belke.
Okay, so I got two recent Bigfoot sightings that I will I'll bring up on the screen here so we all can take a look at it together. And I hate to burst Joe's bubble, but Bigfoot does exist. And
well, they're saying in the chat that I'm drunk and I need to go home.
Yeah.
I saw Bigfoot at a tractor pull.
You're drunk and you don't know what you're saying. I understand.
And then it says, Joe, go listen to Sasquatch Chronicles. You're wrong. Y-O-U-R.
Yes. So that's clearly the correct way to say it. Like you possess wrong.
It's mine.
you possess wrong. You know, Bigfoot does exist, and to the uninformed, I can understand.
Oh, to be fair, Mike, they just shaved one and got him elected to the Senate. So
yeah, I mean, he could be the first cryptid senator. That's for sure. This first sighting comes from, oh boy, I think the Northeast. Let's see here. But there's some footage here. So this has been going around, and there's a black large figure up on a hill. They appear to be about, I'm going to say, 200, 300 yards away. I will play this, and then we'll move on to the next one.
Seriously, look how big it is. Seriously, look how... I don't think it is a human. I think it's a Sasquatch.
It was a bluebird January morning here in the foothills of Northeast Provo when a group of guys saw a figure on the mountain that looked like they've never seen before.
You can't just see something that's maybe a once in a century discovery and go do your 9-to-5 job. You got to go look for fur or footprints or some kind of evidence.
And the camera was rolling as Austin took to the mountain with a buddy on a search for the elusive Bigfoot.
So I'm seeing something that is not deer tracks anymore. We're trying to determine what it is.
Their findings were inconclusive.
Was it a bear? Maybe. That's plausible. What is a person? Also plausible. Was it something else? I think that's also plausible. Who knows?
On the other hand, I spoke to a curator from the Natural History Museum of Utah who says not only is that figure in the video not Sasquatch, but it's safe to say that Sasquatch is not something that would even exist.
What's the likelihood that there are big animals that have gone undetected by scientists and by trained observers?
Dr. Eric Rickhart has spent much of his career exploring places people have never gone before in search of new species. So far, no Bigfoot or anything like it.
There are lots of undiscovered things, particularly in the natural world. But they don't take the form of giant apes running around in largely settled areas of the world.
So what do you believe?
I'm really hoping I get to go look again. Maybe there's something out there to find right here in Utah, even in Provo.
There you go. There is a news report balanced to what Joe believes, that according to the professor, there's just a very, very, very small chance that a large primate is out there hiding in woods and hasn't been discovered, hasn't been captured, hasn't been properly documented. But I think that it is possible. And the more I read about the Bigfoot stuff, and especially like David Politis' stuff, people are seeing something. And it is very curious. And I am a full-on believer that Bigfoot most likely does exist. It's just they're so elusive, Joe. They're very crafty at hide-and-go-seek. And I have one more Bigfoot thing right here. Then we'll move on.
I just want to say that these people, like, if they're parents and they have children, this is how the cycle continues, because it's look at me, give me attention. I'm going to talk about Bigfoot like it's a real thing. Mm-hmm. Meanwhile, their kids are being neglected. So they're going to get into some other random shit, like probably like I'm a... you know, tranny or whatever.
So you think
I need attention.
You think if you're a parent and also a Bigfoot hunter, you're abusing your kids.
You're neglecting your children. I'm looking for Bigfoot instead of raising my, raising a family.
To be fair, Joe, they parked those kids in front of TikTok. They gave them the tablet. They're good.
Yeah.
Well, here's a Bigfoot. A hunter alleged or captures alleged Bigfoot on camera during trip to Birch Forest. Another video clip of the alleged Sasquatch has just appeared online, but is it really an unknown hominid or just a prankster in a suit? The footage, which was uploaded on YouTube, a channel called NVTV yesterday, begins with a brief backstory stating the individual who submitted this was a hunter and had been out in the woods when he saw something unexpected and decided to hide in the bushes to get a closer look. When the creature moved away, he attempted to follow it, but it was too quick and he couldn't keep up. No specific details of exactly when and where the video was recorded was provided. And so unknown person. So we'll take a look at this. And what we're looking at, to everyone just listening at home, is like a large black shadowy creature moving from right to left in the screen. It is very poor quality.
Loch Ness Monster.
It's very frustrating. All this kind of shitty footage.
Why is he moving the camera so much?
I don't know. He's got the standard Bigfoot camera, the shaky camera.
Yeah. Does everyone buy their cell phone at the same place?
This is what's incredibly frustrating about this. Is that
throw up.
No one will just remain still. I don't care how terrified you are. Stay the fuck still. This is the most important footage you're ever going to capture in your entire life. And if you can't do like the bare minimum of remaining quiet and still, don't upload it. And so what we're seeing on screen here, so this guy is approaching with his camera to this area. He's about, I would say, 75 yards away from where the creature's going to stand up.
Yeah. Was it sitting there taking a shit?
Yes. The Bigfoot was squatting down, taking a crap, and it got up and started walking from right to left. And it's kind of hunched over, like it's looking down a little bit. But surprisingly, like there's no definition on this creature. Whatever.
It looks mopey.
Yes.
It looks like he's sad.
He's very sad, very depressed Bigfoot.
So blood in his stool again. Oh.
Well, yeah, he's looking down. He's like, oh my God, I shouldn't have had Taco Bell last night.
I don't remember eating that.
I mean,
I got to go see a doctor.
When did I have corn?
Hey, corn 2 weeks ago.
I'm going to have to shave myself again and go into town and see a doctor.
But this Bigfoot, yeah, it is very mopey, but also like when it comes to its hair, there's no real definition. There's no sun like bouncing off of it. It's almost like just a black mass. It's like it's all black, like matte black.
It's a good album, by the way.
But there's no, it's just very curious that there's not a lot of definition. If it is a guy in a costume, I would expect to see some more details from the costume, like anything. But right, we're not.
Mike, I'm gonna give you a link here. See if you can do this. Here's some live production for you. You have to run audio from this while showing you the video of the Bigfoot walking.
Okay, I'll see what I can do. I'll bring this up. Okay. It is. It's a mopey Bigfoot, sad Bigfoot.
Good call, Crescent.
And there he goes. He's walking away.
And so for people who may not know, the younger folks, with this music is the Incredible Hulk, isn't it?
Sad Hulk, yes. Music, yeah. Yeah. And now he lost the Bigfoot. It just went back into the woods. And this guy, the cameraman, didn't even give chase, like any kind of extreme chase. Like you can kind of see him starting to run right now. But there we go. Well, I'm a believer in Bigfoot. I believe that he's out there. I foolishly declared I thought 2022 was going to be the year of Bigfoot, big discoveries, big images, big videos, and so far, not as much as I'd like to see. But there's about a month and a half left, so we'll see what happens.
Music kills me.
No.
So here's a question. If you are one of these outdoorsy types, you enjoy your hunting, your hiking, your backpacking, and your camping, and you come across some, you know, herd of deer or something, you stand still and watch the deer. You don't jump out in the open and swing your camera around wildly, but apparently for Bigfoot you do.
There's some good sightings out there though. David Politis on his Missing 411 YouTube show has been giving doing like the Bigfoot 101, basically all the information that he's collected, and he's written a few books on Bigfoot. That's initially how he got started into the paranormal research. Like he's most notably famous for Missing 411 and all that kind of stuff. But originally he was hired to look at Bigfoot, collect evidence, collect DNA, and he started collecting also affidavits, sworn testimony about what people have seen. And this is all most of his investigations, I believe, revolved around some Native American areas And the Native Americans have just a long history with Bigfoot. He collected a lot of evidence. I think he has two books on Bigfoot. Pretty fascinating stuff. And he also has his own collection of DNA that he has collected over the time. So it doesn't mean anything
did
to
he
Joe.
Do that?
What's that?
How did he collect the DNA?
I think he found it in a bathroom. But
in this footage, we see Bigfoot stood up as if he was copping a squat behind the tree there. So, you know, did David Pilatus know about this footage? Did he run off there to go collect that?
I don't think he got that exact dump, but he got some other dumps.
Oh, I hit the glory hole right here.
But there you go. There's some Bigfoot. There's some activity out there. Keep your eyes and ears out there open, people, because Bigfoot is all around. And I think next spring, I'm going to try to go out Bigfoot hunting myself here in Ohio, looking for the Ohio Grassman.
And we want all of the listeners who are hunting Bigfoot, if you see one, make sure you're epileptic.
Yes, and start shaking your camera continuously.
Record it while you're having a seizure.
Mm-hmm.
Please.
That's what we're hoping for.
Give us an email at ourbigdumbmouth@gmail.com. Check out obdmpod.com for all the social media and donation links.